In 2009, a backhoe operator was digging for rocks at a quarry in West Texas when his backhoe suddenly broke through the quarry floor, which collapsed into an undiscovered cavern. A few months later, two paleontologists and a graduate student climbed down into the newly discovered cave to see if there were any interesting fossils.
It was nice to duck my head inside the cave and right away just kind of glance over to my left and see, oh, there's a dog fossil. And the bone feels very old. It has a China-like feel to it. It's very fragile. And then when we found the ground sloth, we thought, okay, yeah, we'll come back. It's definitely worth coming back if there's ground sloth in here. So that was kind of fun.
Wait, did you catch that? They found the ankle bone of a giant ground sloth, an animal that hasn't lived in North America for thousands of years, not since the last ice age. You might not have noticed, but Chris Bell was really, really excited.
And then when we found the ground sloth, we thought, okay, yeah, we'll come back.
Ice age fossils from this part of West Texas are very rare. So finding a hidden stash of them could tell paleontologists a lot about which animals lived here at different times and what the climate was like. The reason the fossils survived so long is that the cave has been mostly sealed off from the outside world for thousands of years. But that all changed when a new entrance was accidentally opened up.
It turns out that the entrance to the site is a topographic low for the area. And the consequence of that is anytime it rains here, we get a flood coming through the cave. And actually that happened when we were here in May, so we actually got to see it happen. And in the meantime, in the intervening months since we were here in May and the time that we came back, a significant portion of Cone 1 had actually been eroded back and cut away.
When it rains, bits of ancient bone wash down to the lower reaches of the cave. With each heavy rain threatening to wash away more fossils, Bell led a crew of graduate students, renowned paleontologist Ernie Lundelius, a museum naturalist, and a science communicator, hey, that's me, on a fossil dig to see what we could recover.
So we're working with hand tools, not big shovels and picks. We're in there with trowels, little masonry trowels, paintbrushes, whisk brooms, toothbrushes, dental picks, and pulling out little material, trying to identify fragile fossil material as we find it and wrap it up in fossil wrapping paper. Some people call it toilet paper. And then put it in a special vial and keep it separate. And then we put the material in a bucket and we send it out the cave. And there's another team of people that are working outside the cave, looking through that material, pulling out as many rocks as they can to reduce the volume that we have to haul back home. And they bag up all the sediment that they're keeping and all the fossils are in there, and we will take all that back to Austin.
This isn't like the movies. It's slow, tedious work. With a rotating crew of two people digging for 3 days straight, we remove enough dirt, rock, and bone to fill the trunk of a small car. And yet, for such a small excavation, we found a bonanza of bone. Here's Chris Bell running down a list of some of the critters they've identified so far.
We have a frog, a snail, turtle, lizard, snake, birds, shrews, pack rats, a coyote that was on the slope, sloth, mountain lion, an antilocaper. We have a camel, and we have horse.
Whew! Now, based on radiocarbon dates and where each fossil sat in relation to each other, Bell and his colleagues will start to piece together the story of how animal populations changed in this part of West Texas during the Ice Age.